two major breaking news stories today involving two major airlines and the Airbus A380. Next on Maximus. Lufthansa to ground entire Airbus A380 fleet. Amid plunging demand due to the coronavirus outbreak, Lufthansa is taking some major steps with its A380 fleet. After previously considering grounding its entire A380 fleet, Lufthansa is now preparing to ground the type through May. According to AeroDE, Lufthansa is taking the A380 out of service through May per an internal circular. This comes as the airline has seen a slump in bookings. Shockingly, however, Lufthansa has only notched a 35% occupancy rate on the A380s recently. At this time, Lufthansa has denied the rumor, but with plummeting demand, it is looking more and more likely by the day. In addition, Lufthansa is also working on a plan for its crew and parking the Airbus A380s on top of other aircraft across Lufthansa Group that are effectively grounded. Thus, it would make sense for Lufthansa to not publicly announce the details until the entire plan for this grounding has been confirmed. And on the heels of this Lufthansa news, there are rumors out of Australia that Qantas is preparing to ground Airbus A380s. With passenger numbers continuing to slide, Qantas is poised to ground six of its A380s. The mega jumbos fly to destinations such as London, Los Angeles, and Singapore. But multiple sources over the weekend suggest the Qantas A380s are set for some downtime, a bare-bones service set to be further reduced. Presently, Qantas runs the A380s on services between Sydney and Los Angeles, Sydney and London via Singapore, Sydney and Dallas, and Melbourne and Los Angeles. When demand was better, you could have seen the A380s on routes into Hong Kong and Tokyo. Now demand is such that the already bare-bones A380 services are set to be further reduced. Qantas operates a fleet of 12 A380 aircraft, albeit one of them are usually out of service undergoing a cabin refurbishment. However, it looks like Qantas plans to ground six of the A380s and substitute smaller aircraft onto those routes. And with capacity reductions elsewhere, the airline has Dreamliners and A330s to spare. With travel to and through Asia hit particularly hard by the coronavirus outbreak, there is some speculation that Qantas may temporarily reroute its flagship A380 Sydney to London service through Dubai rather than Singapore. The news comes hot on the heels of Qantas again reducing capacity into Asia last week. The airline has canceled several services between Sydney and Sapporo, Sydney and Osaka, Sydney and Hong Kong, Melbourne and Narita, Melbourne and Auckland, and Brisbane and Narita. A Qantas spokesperson said further cuts to service were likely. The coronavirus situation and its impact on international travel demand is evolving, and we're monitoring it closely. Further changes are expected. Qantas is, however, well-placed to weather the current travel downturn. The airline has previously pointed to its diversified business portfolio and strong balance sheets as buffers. There is also the view that Qantas should not and will not waste a crisis. There is always opportunity in a crisis. Qantas is due to announce Project Sunrise any day now. There are two schools of thought on this. The first is that Qantas will use the downturn in travel demand as the perfect excuse to drop the idea. The second school of thought is that now is the perfect time to launch Project Sunrise. With transits, and particularly Asian port transits, so unpopular right now, direct flights that bypass problem zones should appeal. Many also believe that Qantas will use the current period of uncertainty to drive through IR reform and wage deals. With a surplus of pilots on the market, Qantas has the upper hand to extract maximum efficiencies and minimum pay increases as it moves to reset various enterprise bargaining agreements. Despite Qantas's ability to deal with the downturn in travel, it is a tough operating environment with no immediate relief on the horizon. The grounding of six A380s will most likely form part of the next round of capacity reductions at Qantas. But what happens after that is anybody's guess. And as for Lufthansa, amid a slump in demand, it makes sense for Lufthansa to ground the A380s through May or longer in order to reduce losses. While Lufthansa has not yet confirmed this, it would make sense for the airline to wait to organize final details before definitively announcing plans to ground the A380s. And if load factors are to be believed, then it is all the more reason for Lufthansa to ground this type. So there you have it, some breaking news out of Australia and Germany involving the A380. We know they're getting ready to phase out the A380 in most airlines, and Airbus has stopped production of it, but apparently that seemed to be a little breaking news there. So thanks for joining me. Like, subscribe, ring the bell, and share. And as always, leave the rubber on the runway and your troubles on the ground, and I'll see you next time in the air. This is Maximus.